welcome, CJ. I am going to do a SID departure for you out of Miami. This is going to be the SID that coincides with that packet that I gave you. It's the Miami RNAV skips one. We're going to be departing off the runway that we're going to be flying, which is 26 left. I'm going to show you how to do this in a Boeing 767. I already have everything all programmed and ready to go. We're ready for depart, just to release our brakes and depart. I'm going to pull up the CDU. Alright, here's our route that you'll see is in here. Jada, Grit, Colby, Nikki, Krabby One, and Skips. You notice there are no altitude restrictions that are in here. I've gone through and double-checked that. According to this, you'll be assigned an altitude to maintain until you are given further clearance. That would require ATC upon our clearance to say fly and maintain 6,000 feet until further, and then they'll 10 minutes after departure, they'll give you your climb to as filed. We're pretending that we can climb to as filed already, so I've got everything all set up in here. I have you can see already in here, the purple line is our SID that's set up in here. The aircraft is configured for takeoff. The only warning that we have now is our brakes. We do have our speed set and our altitude set. I'm not going to use the autopilot, but we will use the flight director, which will take information from the autopilot system and from here. And the throttles will be set to auto throttle, so I won't have to control those. Now, that being said, this aircraft is a little picky. I got this from Captain Sim, and if I didn't get it on such a huge discount, I wouldn't be happy with the purchase. It eats frame rates, and I've had to turn the quality down on it just to get it to where I can record this video with over 10 frames per second. However, with that, I got the aircraft for $12 versus the normal $45 for it, so I got a huge discount on it. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and depart now. I'll explain what we're going to be doing throughout, and I have it typed out for you, and it's also on the chart that I give you again. This is the SID RNAV skips one. The RNAV means that you're required to have GPS based off of a VOR. You need to have a DME. You have to have your IRU working or a GPS, so now you know your exact position. So with that, we're going to begin our takeoff. We're going to climb to a heading of our altitude of 520 is where we need to be before we pass over JADAC. That again is a sound, what they call a sound restriction or noise abatement procedure. Then once we're above there, we'll turn to a heading of 262, which all that's already programmed in. Basically, we're just going to follow the purple line downhill. And the purple lines here, this will tell us where to turn and what pitch we need to maintain our climb and our speed. And again, we won't have to worry about the throttles, the auto throttle will take care of that. So again, we're going to take off, climb to 520 feet, we will push the LNAV button. And what that'll do is the LNAV button will then command the purple line here to follow the lateral navigation. As far as our altitude will go, it'll just pick a vertical speed. It's not going to follow any profile because I don't have a complete route built. I'm just following the SID. Alright, let's release our brakes and take off. And set flaps. I have not set our V speeds in here, so I'm just going to guess, and I'll give it a good 550 before I rotate. We have plenty of runway for that. Here's 550. What we're going to try and do is you just want to keep a plus sign right here. This is going to maintain this current heading right now until I hit the LNAV button. You'll see LNAV is on there, and we're still climbing it, but you'll see it shifted just a little bit. ship, there's a 500, you know, a couple of inches off. We're going to turn to a heading of 262. Gets difficult is when you're flying an aircraft that doesn't have a CDU in it or an FMC, and you have to know that you have to tune different VORs and know that 5 minutes after departure I need to turn to this altitude or to this heading, and I need to be at this altitude, and then I need to switch to this VOR. You know, this is pretty easy. This is just following the lines. It's not that difficult. Again, this is an RNAV. There are VOR departures and other things that you'd have to, you know, different ones to follow. But when we do the 747, it's going to be just like this, only the displays are actually going to be easier to read in it, because it'll be a next-gen cockpit. This is like in between. You'll see that there's a combination of the glass cockpit instead of steam gauges that we had to follow. Again, I'm flying this all by hand, so you can see this is very easy to follow. Keep it at 250 just to keep it simple. did discover in this aircraft is that the it's hard to sometimes click on here, and you'll notice sometimes too, like, what pops up isn't what you're actually touching. It's weird, but it's just a matter of changing the views. Everything. The important thing is in these advanced jets, such as the 747-400 with the glass cockpits, and the stuff is the programming of this computer right here. It's all in our pre-flight. If you follow the checklist and you get this computer programmed correctly, flying is not that hard. It's pretty much just a bunch of switches. You don't even need to turn the autopilot on. It'll display all your information on these two pages that you would need. All you have to do is just set the correct numbers in here so that it matches with the flight director. I flew this pretty much manually up to almost 20,000 feet, and it hit the autopilot, and other than the auto command light on here and there, there really is not much of a difference between when I was flying and when the autopilot was flying. Alright, I hope this helps you again. Just practice this as much as you want. You can set up the route that I gave you, and just keep practicing it. The next video will be how to land at St. Martin using the VOR, which is very simple compared to this. And I'm not sure if I'm going to use the this aircraft or if I'll use a different one. I might just use the MD-11 to get some better results with fraps and recording. Alright, have a good one.